Today, I am super excited because not only do we get to do a proof by contradiction, we also get to dig into the origins of irrational numbers and talk about the mathematical mysticism of the Pythagoreans. I love talking about the number system because it's so rich in history. It took humans centuries to discover all the numbers that we have today. For instance, before the 6th century BC, people thought all numbers were irrational. And you can see why. I mean, how often in your everyday lives do you stumble across numbers that aren't whole numbers or fractions? I mean, without advanced math, not very often. Now, back in ancient Greece, philosophers were beginning to take numbers very seriously, especially a group of mathematicians led by Pythagoras. The Pythagoreans were a cultish group who worshipped numbers and the ratios of numbers. So you can see that the idea of a number that couldn't be expressed as a ratio of two whole numbers was completely taboo. Ironically, it is the Pythagorean theorem itself that leads us to the discovery of irrational numbers. You may recall that a 45-45-90 degree triangle has side lengths in the ratio of 1-1 square root 2. It is that square root 2 that is so troublesome to the Pythagoreans. But before I continue with this story, let's prove that the square root of 2 truly is irrational. To do this, we are going to use a proof by contradiction. In this type of proof, we start with an assumption, generally something that's opposite of what we're trying to prove. And then, through a series of logical steps, we create a self-contradiction within the proof. It is this self-contradiction that allows us to say that the opposite of our assumption is true. So, to get started on any proof by contradiction, you generally want to make an assumption, and that assumption needs to be the opposite of what you're trying to prove. So in this problem, we are trying to prove that the square root of 2 is irrational. So I'm going to start my proof by assuming that the square root of 2 is rational instead of irrational. Now we want to use a series of logical steps to create a self-contradiction. So at this point, I ask myself, what does being rational mean? Since we're doing a proof, it is important that we use real words to actually describe what we're doing here. So I just went ahead and wrote that we then can write square root 2 as the ratio of two integers, say p and q. So p and q are just the variables I chose. You could choose any letters. And then I say that that means that the square root of 2 is equal to p over q. At this point, we can say that p and q have no common factors. And that's because if they did have common factors, we could simply reduce this fraction and come up with a smaller integer p and integer q. So it's safe to say that p and q have no common factors. And I'm just going to write that down next. So how I described that in words, I just said, we can assume that p and q have no common factors. And then in parentheses, just for good measure, I said, since if they did, we could reduce our fraction and choose a new p and q as those integers. All right, so now that we've established that, let's go ahead and do a little bit of math with our square root 2 equals p over q here. First thing I'm going to do is square both sides and see what happens. And then let's go ahead and get rid of this fraction. This is sort of just a little bit of scratch work that maybe you would do on a separate sheet of paper before you solved your proof, and then in your final write-up of the proof, you would know to do these steps. So if you're doing these proofs on your own and you're not getting them on the first shot, that's okay, because usually you're doing a lot of scratch work to figure out the correct steps. I've already figured out these steps, so you're not seeing the scratch work, but that is how I know to do this next. So now I have 2q squared equals p squared. So at this point, you may notice that p squared is an even number because it is equal to 2q squared, and this factor of 2 will make it even. So I'm going to go ahead and say that p squared is even, and if p squared is even, then p must be even as well, since we know from previous proofs and knowledge that any even number squared is an even number. So because p is an even number, we can say that p equals 2 times n, where n is an integer. And that's just the definition of even. So if p equals 2n, then p squared equals 2n squared, which is equal to 4n squared. That implies that p squared is divisible by 4. So our final step here is just to put all of this information together. So we have that p squared equals 4n squared, and we also know that p squared equals 2q squared. So I'm going to go ahead and put those all as one line. So now I'm going to divide both of these by 2, and we find that q squared equals 2n squared. Okay, so you might be thinking, wow, this is a lot of steps. Where are we going with this? So here is the critical step of our proof. So we have now said that q squared is equal to 2n squared. And because it has a 2 as its factor, q squared is also even, which means that q is even, which means that both p and q are even, which means that they have a common factor of 2 at minimum. And we said in our assumption that they didn't have any common factors because we can choose the most reduced form of p and q. So that's our self-contradiction. So we have found that both p and q are even, which means they both have factors of 2. This is a contradiction because we've established that p and q have no common factors. Once you find your contradiction, you are now allowed to say that the opposite of your assumption is true. So we assumed that the square root of 2 is rational. Because we've made a contradiction to ourselves, we can now safely say that the square root of 2 is not rational, or in other words, is irrational. And that's the last line of our proof. So all we have to do is write that, and we have finished. And of course, to signify that our proof is over, we can write QED or do a little black box. So how did discovery of irrational numbers go over with our whole number worshiping Pythagoreans? Well, it was a bit controversial. The story commonly told is a bit of math folklore, but it is rumored that Hippasus, the member of the Pythagoreans who discovered that square root of 2 was irrational, died at sea shortly after the discovery. Now, was it the gods frowning down upon him, as the Pythagoreans claimed? An accident? Or murder? We may never know. But what we do know is that the square root of 2 is indeed irrational. Until next time, this has been Math Hacks, and thanks for watching.